friend zone, she turned on more. Ooh. Take one for the team, I do that for my boy.
Bread, gang, time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man, I bet we win it. Go hard or go home, it's survival of the fittest. Whoa.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. Activate. Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another sack, cause I be running.
It's just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics. Everything was ablaze. Everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Chicago Bears. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And an early how do you do right there as they're going to bury him in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you
pressure and he's taken down, a bear sack. Call it a loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down.
Two plays so far, run and a pass attempt, and both have gone backwards.
Probably not how they drew that up.
Not at all.
Looking for a better play coming up on third. And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. They'll set up a throw. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback, because he went into it, he saw the numbers we saw, he watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be, but early in this one, advantage defense.
One play action, Fields. Toward the end zone, but that's gonna wind up incomplete.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've gotta find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
5 yards, now it's third and five.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, and now they look up at a third and five. Now Fields drops this off with Nwangu, and they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked it down to force a fourth down?
Santos' kick is up and through, and it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, They have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Meanwhile, the throw here is complete, and they're able to get this one across the 35.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he'll be stopped right at midfield. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes
when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game. And all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's got his tight end. It's Tommy Trumbull. Touchdown, Panthers! For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards and just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Back to throw, Fields. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. They get... there, but it brings up fourth. Here's Mitch Wishnowsky now. And a fake here. Direct snap to the up man. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. So they get the first down. Maybe not a huge play in terms of yardage, but the fake punt does the job. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Fields. He's going to look downfield for Henry. And incomplete on the deep ball.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Back to the air, Fields on second down. That's complete to Mooney. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they had certainly had their struggles to start the season, but they put it all together in getting that first victory a week ago.
I have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape, because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total, and made it difficult for them to step up and find receivers downfield. Also made it hard for them to escape the pocket and run.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my last scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Panthers will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
They're able to force him out of the pocket right, but still able to complete it. So a first catch for him in the ball game, and you know the scuttlebutt has been he's not getting enough touches, enough catches, not feeling involved enough in the offense, so maybe that can get him going.
You and I both know that there's not a wide receiver alive that ever feels like in any game he got enough touches, even if he got 15, right? We all know.
Now Carson fumbles the football, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Well, obviously, you never want to fumble, but if you do, good to be towards the sideline. It saves them the possession.
Saves the embarrassment, saves it going down on the play sheet as a turnover. But I still think it should go to the defense, even if they don't recover it. If you give up the football, you gave up the football.
Agree to disagree, I guess.
Can you tell what I played?
Yeah, you played defense. Yeah. I'll let you go.
I took a shot.
Here's a ball thrown right side and complete. He's at the 40. The 20. Touchdown, Carolina. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Off play action, Fields. Hunter Henry brings it in. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
On first and 10, here's Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
So a PI call going to cost him there defensively. What did you see?
Well, I think it's the right call, partner, because sometimes we'll see officials kind of let them play. But by the letter of the law, that's definitely a penalty.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the toss, here's Nwangu. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that'll bring up a third and one. A 14-3 ball game. Bears on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. They're up against a third and one situation. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Throwing again on second and 10. Fields. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range, so now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Here's Fields. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone, spaces are a premium for receivers to try and operate and shake themselves free. That one's incomplete.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, this from 34. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll look to throw here. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35, and they're going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On first down, they'll run with DeWongu. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. We've got movement. I think this is against the Bears here. Let's find out. So that'll back him up five. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Here's Fields. Looking for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. Hunter Henry. His third touchdown now on the year. And now the Bears are within a two-point conversion of tying up the game. And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Now the Bears keeping the offense on the field and going for two. They're going to try and run, and he's not going to get there. So they come up empty on the two-point conversion, and they are unable to tie up this football game. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. The previous run, good for nine. Here's second and a yard. He'll look to throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's the option. Finding some room at midfield. The 30! 10! 5! Touchdown, Carolina! Well, we've seen some rookie running backs come in and have a big impact year one, and this guy would certainly fit that bill, as that was one heck of a run there.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates, they're looking at you, and let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to him. That's not how football works, but he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
Yeah, he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. We have witnessed touchdowns on back-to-back drives. We'll see if the offense can continue this uptick here.
And I know you're looking.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. The sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. A play fake, now Fields to throw, and his throw is going to be incomplete.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish, because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works, and that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
That'll be complete to the running back, Nwangu. And he'll be out right at the 35.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Play action. It's Fields. Gets this to Ferkser, the tight end. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down. On the give is Nwangu. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
2 first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. And the pass to Henry is intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthers are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right, it felt like a matter of time. And you got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. On play action, they'll throw. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Well, they certainly spread the ball around so far, but they're definitely getting everyone involved now when they're throwing it to the fullback. Just shows how versatile this offense is and how everyone is a threat.
Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. Throw left side complete. That's Carson. Touchdown! A great play there. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
And 3 touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Here's 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, Fields. Flush to his right. And he will not throw it away. He goes out of bounds, well shy of the line of scrimmage, so that's a sack.
The scoreboard tells a story for him, a little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
The Bears on 3rd down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 16. Fields now to throw. He's got a man complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. Touchdown. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, here's Fields. And that nearly intercepted. The free safety roaming into position almost had it, but it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. On first down, it's Fields. Drops this off with Nwangu. Touchdown, Bears! Kenny Nwangu. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bears get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Now the Bears keeping the offense on the field and going for two. And this is going to be caught, so they do get it. And the 2 points, now they're back down to a one-score deficit. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead, should they so choose. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And that's complete to McCaffrey. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll set up to throw. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
Back to throw now on first down. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over, then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Second and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. Good footwork at the 30. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Marshall. And those linemen, of course, can't be more than a yard downfield when a pass is thrown, and they might have been able to call that on a couple of guys there. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And it bangs off the right upright, no good. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando. That's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. A shotgun snap, Fields. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Now a give running right, Nwangu. And he will not only not get the yard he needed, he goes the wrong direction. A 5-yard loss there is going to bring up fourth down. Here comes the Bears punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. This will be fielded at the 17. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
That's anything inside 40.
Yeah, they're counting on that going through the post. But we've seen it happen to teams before. Some of the best kickers in the world can miss kicks like that. Can they come back now and redeem themselves?
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. They'll look to throw. Open man left side. It's the tight end Trimble. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. They run with McCaffrey off the option. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters this week? He kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 41. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Oh, and that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Back to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will bump the lead up to 11. So he missed that field goal earlier, but he says not this time. Able to knock it through, give his guys three.
I like his poise. I like his confidence, his belief in himself. Sometimes when you miss that first one, you see a lot of guys sag, and they can't make the next one. Not in this case. Stepped right up like a pro.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
Then they got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Yeah, he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
Give left side here for Nwangu. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I think this running game, or should I say lack of one, is making this defense look better than what they really are.
On second and 12, Fields flushed out right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
Escaping the pressure right. And this defense rallies, and they stop him short of the first down right near the 24.
I liked his effort there. He got it done on his own. But let's face it, he puts defenses in a really stressful spot when he takes off and runs because a lot of guys have coverage responsibilities.
Good job of rallying, though, because I thought when he first took off, he might pick up the first down. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Henry's got it out on the left side. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
What an excellent end result for them. But let's go back to the decision, first of all, to go for it all on fourth down. A lot of pressure on the quarterback's shoulders, but they knew he could handle it. Makes the right read there, gets the ball to his receiver. They get the first down. It's snapped.
Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. A great effort there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bears have cut it to within a score. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And he will not make it into the end zone. But a flag down here, and I think they're going to get another shot at this. Now the Bears keeping the offense on the field and going for two. They'll look to throw. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown.
This taken in at the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. He'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Second and nine now. And this is incomplete.
You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well.
And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Moore with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Panthers are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is, his first miss, no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Off play action, Fields. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10 now, third quarter from Charlotte. Back to throw, Fields. Flush to his right. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. This complete to Henry over the middle. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
Now a first down throw, Fields. Flushed out right. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. A big connection on that one, 39 yards.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Justin Fields keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Bears have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They'll try and throw for it. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points. It gets them back within a field goal. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there and it's second and 11. They'll look to throw here. And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
He finds his man, complete. It's Carson. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
Couldn't just sit on it here, couldn't they? Had to throw the ball third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. McCaffrey on the counter. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball.
Second and 8 coming up.
They'll set up a throw. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down. They'll drop to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And it'll be first and 10 Bears from deep in their own territory. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Interception, and I just had to double check my math, but it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double checking it, but the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard and they never get out of it, and that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way. Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself, because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 41 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there on that play. I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where... And he will score! Touchdown, Panthers! DJ Moore, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And thanks to the interception, the Panthers offense cashes in with 6. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. That throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And this one is incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now it's Fields.
They'll check that down to Nwangu out of the backfield. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
And that's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Josh Jackson. And the Panthers are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. And that's now a half dozen interceptions for him over the last two games. Cassidy, remember, he threw three in the last ball game, and now three more here.
And the way that you present it, partner, I'm not sure what sounds worse, right? Half a dozen over the last two games, or three the last game, three this game. Either way, it's way too many. And that's something they'll have to work on, hoping to get through the rest of this game without having to address it again.
They'll start with the option. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
They'll try and burn some clock now with McCaffrey. And he's going to get forward for about five, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? The Panthers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 7. He'll look to throw. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. Defense still with 3 timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass.